Hello everyone, I'm Sneha and welcome back to my YouTube channel Sneha the Scribbles. Thank you so much for subscribing my channel, and if you have not subscribed it yet, please do so. So today I am here with another video review. Actually, I was planning to start a video review series about series books or box set books like trilogy and two book series and four book set and all that. So to start this series, I am here with one of my favorite trilogy, and it's so special for me as my husband gifted it to me on my 7th anniversary, the beautiful Taj trilogy by Indu Sundaresan. The first book of this series is The 28th Wife. The second is The Feast of Roses. And the third is The Shadow Princess. Of course, it's all about the Mughal Empire and all. As you have seen, the covers are so beautifully designed and make us pick the book instantly. And I was always fascinated by Taj, and I think most of you are, because there are rich culture and history behind the making of Taj and the Mughal Empire. The Taj trilogy consists of three books, as I have shown you earlier: The 28th Wife, The Feast of Roses, and The Shadow Princess. The series as a whole chronicles the timeline of Mughal Emperor in India, Akbar, Jahangir, and Shah Jahan. I have to say this is one of the best historical novel I have read so far, and history is not my favorite subject. It's huge coming from me. The 28th Wife is a story of Mehrunisha, and covers her journey from birth to getting married to Salim. She is the 28th wife of Salim. She is the daughter of refugee from Persia, Jia-ul-Beg. And she grows up in the fringes of Emperor Akbar's opulent palace grounds, and She first encounters Salim on his wedding day. 8 years old at the time, she decides that she too will. Mehrunisa and Salim's quest takes them and the vast empire that hangs in the balance to places they have never dreamed possible. And The Feast of Roses, the second book of the series, revolves around their married life. It starts with when she got married to Salim. And the first woman Jahangir loves and married her. She is called Empress Noor Jahan. As a mark of his love, he transfers his power of sovereignty to her. But she has a formidable rival in the imperial harem, Empress Jagat Ghosni, who had plotted against her from the moment she entered the emperor's life. Beyond the harem walls, she battles powerful ministers who are not willing to allow a mere woman to have a say in the outside world, defying all established norms of womanhood in 17th century India. Mehrunisa combats her rival by forming a junta of sorts with the three men she can rely on: her father, her brother, and Jahangir's son Prince Khurram, who later known as Shah Jahan. She demonstrates a great strength of character and cunning to get what she wants, sometimes at great personal cost, even almost losing her daughter's love. But she never loses the love of the man who bestows this power upon her, Emperor Jahangir. And the episode, The Feast of Roses, is so captivating it could leave the reader in rust, and I can actually feel the moment playing in front of my eyes, and it was so mesmerizing and lovely and delicate, and at the same time it was so empowering that he bestowed her the greatest honor by allowing her to not only touch the shadow of the king, but also to overcome his shadow. It was so beautifully written. And then the third book of the trilogy, The Shadow Princess, which is a story of Mumtaz and Shah Jahan, and the real story behind the building of Taj Mahal. The Mughal Empire is crumbling with the death of his beloved Queen Mumtaz. Emperor Shah Jahan slowly loses interest in everything while his son conspires and schemes to gain control of the empire. Princess Zahara is only 17 when the weight of Imperial Jarana is thrust upon her. She was Shah Jahan's favorite daughter, and she consoled him after Mumtaz's wife, and she got hold of all the harem, and she was literally the not the only the princess, but she was the main of administration in Jahanana, and she has a great say in Shah Jahan's court also. Although she fall in love with one of the courtiers, but Shah Jahan doesn't allow her to marry him, and she got pregnant, and she had a son with him, and she was a middleman between the Aurangzeb and the Dara Shikoh, and she played all her life. She just spent with in the Mughal emperor court and solving their household problem. All the while the Taj Mahal was building, and you will be surprised to know that in fact the Taj Mahal had taken its inspiration from the tomb that Noor Jahan built for her father Ghia Beg, also known as Itimudullah. Sorry for my pronunciation. But it's so beautiful to read the journey and the history behind the making of Taj Mahal, and the conspiracy is going on the Mughal emperor and Mughal empire, and it's so heavy at some times and so emotional at some times, and it almost feels like real that you are living their life and you are seeing their journey and all that. The book is full of beautiful poetry by Sundaresan, sometimes he taken from different historical texts, and she quoted beautifully all that, and the women's play important role in Mughal emperor, and the way they do business and all that thing was quite unknown to me. I have never heard about all that, and it's so endearing to read about all this. There are no graphic description of unnecessary sex or something like that, which is quite gross sometimes. And she portrayed the love story beautifully. She almost covered all the Mughal emperor and the major emperors of Mughal empire, and she doesn't side with anyone. She just presented the history as it is. That's the most beautiful thing about the book, in my opinion. The characters, none of them are too good or too evil. Everyone is driven to good or bad deeds by some event or some fear. And everyone has a number of shades to their behavior, even young Aurangzeb and Dara Shikoh, if you can see that. The beauty of Kashmir and Lahore are well portrayed, and it really warmed the heart. Sundaresan goes behind the scenes and write about the motivation and justification for all the murders and bloodshed and the political conspiracies, and which are quite interesting to read. It's a masterpiece, and I really, really loved it. And if you have loved my review, please like, comment, and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Take care. Till then, I come back with another review. Bye bye.